back onto Cmake. I'm just going to check what other tabs I've got. You can see this has shrunk down quite a lot now. We're finally getting through some of these dependencies and circular dependencies, all to get back to building Falkon, rebuilding it with the two Qt packages built correctly with all their options. So yeah, we're getting there at last. So I think for Cmake it was just curl that needed to be reinstalled. So I'll just check my notes. It does say for the options, so I can't see that any other options need to be installed there. Qt 5 is required. Now, is that for... It's not the same as Qt Web Engine, is it? No. So, let's have a look at this. So this has still got a lot of dependencies that need to be installed. I think I'm going to start looking at some of these dependencies, get through these to allow me to build Qt 5 in total. The Qt base GUI. Then I'll know it's complete. Just check what other requirements are. So Cmake, there's nothing else apart from Qt. LLVM needs rsync and pyyaml. Cmake ICU, that's what needs LLVM. And Qt Web Engine. So that needs Qt 5 as well. JS. Alright, so ICU is for Falkon then, is it? No, why do I need ICU? Was it, oh, there it is, there, yeah, built before. Sure, why it says ICU built before libxml 2.2. Maybe it does need ICU, does need libxml 2.2, maybe. Right, I think I'm going to be juggling things around a little bit here. Now I'm not sure why I've got these other packages at the end of this list here. No doubt they're for other dependencies that still haven't been covered. So I'm tempted to get rid of these for now. No, I might just leave them for the moment and just stick with this Qt5. That could come up as part of these dependencies here. So I'm going to start going through these, ticking them off. So we can do this out of library. So save that. So I need to check some of the kernel configuration settings. So the first one is config sound. And if you remember, we checked the .config file. So you can see it's set to yes, so that's enabled. And then config snd. And there's loads there, but what do we want? Config snd, imagine it be at the top. Yep, it's set to yes. And there's some other options there, so we'd have to double check that the settings are correct. If the sound doesn't work, it might need a bit of tweaking there. So apart from that, we can build it. There's no options to set here, so configure and build. Here that's built, so not installed in the API documentation, so I'll just run make check to test what we've built. And now, as the root user, install the library. And that's it, there's some information about configuration files. Apart from that, we can tidy it up and mark it off as complete in chapter 42. So you can see we're getting onto more like the multimedia type things here, which is what Qt5 is to do with. And again, this will be beneficial for when we come to do some of the higher level packages, some of the desktop environments and other packages that involve multimedia, video and audio type stuff. So next we've got cups. This is for it's a printing system, so this is highly advisable to install this. Okay, so this has got LVM, which is something we're going to build. Cmake, it's a Qt base GUI. I wonder if we can actually build Cmake to get that GUI. It's not necessary completely, it's a developer type thing. I'm not even sure if it exists at the moment. No, it doesn't. Maybe we didn't create it. So there is a switch here to create it. If I can build Cmake without having to do all the options on Qt, then I think what I'll do is, after it's built, go to LLVM, complete that, and then, well, that lets me complete ICU, but it also lets me go back to Qt to finish off the rest of these dependencies, so that might actually be the best thing to do. So, yeah, let's, I've downloaded this already, so let's extract Cmake again. And reinstall it. So I'll do this set on its own. And then the bootstrap command, which has got some configuration in. And let's just check these system libs. JSON C. So there isn't any options for JSON C, is there? No. And libr hash, that's not there either. So they're not options to build. It is forcing, the way the BLFS book says to do it, is to force that these are built within the Cmake package. So this is one I want to add. So it's purely optional. And parallel to enable bootstrap multiple jobs. I guess that's a four we've got to put there. So let's see if that runs. Okay, so that bootstrap has finished. So build time shouldn't be too long according to this, and the tests a similar amount of time. So let's see how long it takes to build this time. So that's all built successfully. So the thing we need to do now is to test the package, and we've got a command here which we can copy and paste. And we just need to, well, I'm going to put time in, and we just need to set the number of jobs to run in parallel with this here. Just rub out the brackets in and put the four or whatever number of cores you've got. And execute that. So those tests have completed, and we've got zero failed out of 635, so all passed. So I'm going to reinstall this now. Make install. And that's Cmake reinstalled. So I'll mark that off, chapter 13. And get rid of this tab.